morning, everybody. Good morning. I think the last time you guys saw a video, I delivered a load in Gas City, Ohio. Then we went to Michigan, delivered a load in Kalamazoo, and then we picked up a load in Kalamazoo that went to North Platte, Nebraska. Then we picked up a load in Lexington, Nebraska. Now we're sitting in St. Joe, Missouri. We delivered a load in St. Joe, Missouri. Now we gotta go back to our 90 and pick up an empty because they didn't have an empty. Their plant was down. I was just told that there is some empties now. So we're going over there to pick up one. And then we take that empty and we're picking up in St. Joe at a different place though, that is going to Georgia. Now, that load was supposed to get picked up yesterday, but we can't go in there with an empty trailer, right? So I waited and waited and waited because they told me sit there and wait. They're gonna offload one of them trailers for you. Well, I sat until I had 20 minutes left on my logbook. And then I finally told them, I said, well, my 14 is almost over. I'm gonna go to the truck stop, go to bed. So that's what we did. Right now, currently, we're bobtailing.
In 900 feet, turn right on Commonwealth Drive. In 900 feet,
and it is foggy, guys.
Left on I-29 North, US 71 North.
Very foggy this morning. didn't see that truck on the shoulder till I got just about up on it. Foggy. That sun comes up, it'll burn the fog off though. Might be her. There's a window open over there. I'm gonna go ahead and see. I think I see her over there by that one truck, but I'm gonna see if there's somebody else in the office. I'll be right back. Alrighty, real nice lady, man. That's the way to start your day off, right? You look pretty nice. Alright, let's go see if we can find this trailer. I guess we're gonna look for this 200928 first, because that's the trailer that they gave us. In other words, they know that one's empty. We're gonna see if we can find that one first. I did see a trailer over here, looked like a prime trailer. Matter of fact, well, that's 160. In between the buildings, I think he's putting that one in the hole. Matter of fact, I can tell just by the tire squatting that one's loaded. At least they're working today. On the edge, we don't have them lights that you can look in a mirror to see if it's on or not, right? We just got the little red light. So I can tell you that's not our trailer, just this far away. Right there, and that's the trailer that they told me, 200928. So let's see if this one's empty. And again, ain't enough room to fart between them two trailers. I wish they wouldn't pack them in that tight. Let's go take a peek. Watch out, I'm gonna go take a look at this trailer. That's the trailer they gave me, though. Just want to make sure it is empty. It ain't running. The reefer is off. See how bad it is inside. It's empty. It needs washed out, but it's empty. Alright. First things first, let's hook up to this trailer. I'm going to drag it out a little bit too. Can't fit in there. Hook some hoses up. I think I lifted it off the ground about a good 3-4 inches. So I don't think we're gonna drag anything. Watch out there, buddy. Yeah, we ain't gonna drag much. Got her now. I'm blocking the road up a little, but it won't take me but a minute to dolly this up. See, we're a good 3 inches off, 2 inches off the ground. So. I could do some computer work. That way people can get around us. All right. I'm gonna go the other way, but but I can't do it without scraping the other trailer up with my trailer, so I had to come way out here to get past that. And we're gonna go up to the guard. I put in the code for our trailer wash. Our trailer wash. 7.7 miles, we'll get that done. Then we'll go on over and get our load picked up. I think it's a drop and hook, but it could be a... Oh, shit. Okay, I guess I gotta do this. Let me do this. I'm gonna have to turn it around right here. I thought this went all the way around, but I guess it don't. So let's just do this. Hey, what's up? I had to come in here. I was only 4 inches from that other trailer. I couldn't go the other way. I would have scraped them side by side. So I had to come in here. So I thought this went all the way around. So we'll just whip it around and go out that way. All right, man, thanks. I thought this went all the way around. We got her. Too close to that other trailer to go this way. We got her now, guys. Still kind of foggy. Need some more sun to come up, right? Start filming some more. I had an SD card problem, and you know the thing is, it wasn't that old of an SD card, but I kept getting errors, so I ended up buying another one. So hopefully this one will stick, guys. We're hoping anyway. I'll be right back. To open up one of the doors so she can see it was truly empty. Everybody's waving at me today. That's good. Good smile. Everybody's waving. I like that. All right, it's foggy now. We got to be a little more patient now getting out of this parking lot. Can't see far down the road.
Turn left on South Riverside Road, MOAC.
Excuse me. YouTube, because when I was a kid,
trucks. Take the entrance to the right on US 36 West Troy.
Trucks fascinated me, right? I love trucks. Now you can watch it on YouTube.
Take the entrance to the right on US 36 West Troy.
Now you can watch it on YouTube. But got a comment not too long ago saying, "Yeah, trucking sucks, don't it?" And I don't know if that was a kid or an adult. Guessing we can do this. Yep. I'm guessing, you know, well, back in the day, we didn't think that, right? Shoot, man, we were pumping our arms trying to get the trucks to honk. It was a big thing, you know, just to sit inside a big truck. When I was a kid, that was funner than going to a county fair. But I don't think we have that anymore. I don't see people really
continue on this road for 4.6 miles.
Really glamorizing on trucks anymore like it used to be. I don't know if it's because we gave it a black eye or what, but you know. But before you think trucking ain't cool, or trucking is a real bad thing, you think about the importance of this freight going up and down the road and being hauled and delivered. This is the one thing that your police can't do, your fire departments can't do, your doctors can't do. It takes a truck to run this country, North America. It takes the trucks to run North America. And it don't have to be a big 18-wheeler truck. It could be a straight truck or expedite truck. But in all honesty, it takes trucks to move America. And I know there's somebody out there who would probably argue that, yeah, right. Well, if that's the case, you're either not old enough to know, or you was just taught the wrong way the importance of a truck driver, man. And that is what keeps me out here. That's what keeps me going, is knowing that I'm not a soldier. I'm not in the Army or a Marine or a sailor, but I'm servicing our country in a different way, and that is supplying. I'm just 1%, not even probably that, one grain of sand, 0.1%. What I am, one that is helping, servicing our country, delivering our goods and our freight, so you can have something to wear or food or having the lumber that you need to build your house, even the insurance policy that you have that was printed out on paper. That paper was hauled by a truck. Before that, it was hauled by a log truck. You know, they had to take the tree and cut it down and put it on a truck and then take it to a paper mill. And then it took the mill to turn all that scrap wood into liquefied to make paper, so you can have your policy written on a piece of paper. So it was hauled on a truck more ways than you can, from a log truck to the paper mill, and then another truck to haul probably the actual paper that went to the printing. You know, who knows how many trucks did it take to haul from the time it was a tree to the time it turned out to be paper to have your insurance printed on it. See, you know what I'm saying? Everything in some way is hauled by a truck. Now, even if it's hauled across country on a train, it's on a container, and that container is a trailer. And then as soon as it gets at the port and they offload that trailer off that train, it's still going to take a truck to move that trailer to the customer, to the dock.
But 1 mile, take the entrance to the right on Menlo 759 Fort Street Stockyards.
I just don't think people see the importance of trucks. And the spark ain't there, you know, like it used to be. Across the road, and I had to walk over.
Speed limit change possible ahead.
I walked over and got a sandwich at this truck stop, and then I walked back And right there at that truck stop right next to it was a place to wash out the wagon. I've been here before. Truck stop I walked to. Too, just like it is right now.
You're famous, ain't you?
I try to be.
You see? I just looked you up.
We're filming right now.
Are you?
Oh, yeah.
I'll be on there?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah. You too. All right. Let's. to our pickup. Supposed to picked up yesterday, so I'm sure it's gonna be ready now. There was no time yesterday, but kind of dangerous place to pull out. You can't see. You're limited on your sight here. I'm using the spot mirrors because you can't see down the road. So I'm gonna cut that out of there so you won't see the ladies behind the counter, because she didn't want to be on there, and that's fine. You know, she must be running away from something, but I respect that. You know, if you don't want to be on there, you won't be on there. Just because the camera is on doesn't mean that it's gonna be on YouTube anyway, right? Alright, that's right. You guys, you got a weird place to be sitting. hardly ever push the camera on somebody, and if they do see that I'm filming, all they gotta say is I don't want to be on camera. I respect that, I really do. The idea is not trying to be a big bully about, well, you're gonna be on video. If you don't want to be there, you won't be there. The business will be.
2 miles, turn right on Industrial Road, and then approaching destination on the left side in 130 feet.
The business will be, but I won't show her. I won't show their faces. Venture Foods. Oh wait, shipping. Okay, I gotta go here. Third drive. Did not enter. Must be up here. Entrance only. Okay. Check in at. And is this going to be a live load? Right there. All right, I know I can't take you in here, so we'll be right back. All right, we got to take our load bars. Put them inside the trailer so they can put them up on the, you know. That is, that's a plug. It's actually picked up some probably there in Laredo area. The only place I know they make you put plugs in your drain hose. All right, door 14. I'm not gonna drive over there, the door's open. I just gotta find door 14. We're gonna go out this gate, make a right. Door 14 from the road. And he's parked right there. Well, hopefully he's not got me completely, totally blocked. Got two trucks there. In my way now. Up enough so I can open up some doors. Alright. To open up these doors now. Alright, I'll be back, guys. I think I can. think there's enough room? I hope. Nope. God. Froggy, man. I gotta scoot up. Not enough room between the docks. I hate that, man. All right, let's pull up. We're gonna block up the road for a minute. It is what it is. We're gonna block up the road. Don't have enough real estate. Let's pull up so I can do this. I think I'm far enough now. Let's do it. Reefer doesn't work when the doors are open. That's what that light right there means. Throw a chalk underneath the wheel. Look at buddy. To get loaded now. Guys, we're gonna close down this video from here and then we'll film taking off. Come on, you guys wanna say hi? Come on.
Hey, where you at, buddy?
You come up here and say hi?
Jake and Panda?
Yep. We're out here doing our thing. We're getting the freight up and down the road, aren't we, huh?
Yeah.
Having as much fun as we can possibly have.
Yeah.
And we did actually stop. I didn't film it. But we stopped in Lexington, Nebraska. And we did get some food for the truck. So we're good for a little while. Until that starts running out. And then we'll either need it doesn't have to be a Walmart. I always say Walmart. It could be any store that we can actually get into and legally not get in trouble. Yeah. But anyway, thank you for watching. We are in St. Joe, Missouri.
that where we are, St. Joe, Missouri.
We'll see you guys on the next one. Until then, later.